In this next video, we're going to dive deeper into subassemblies. I want to go over the other ways that you can access subassemblies and also learn more about the subassembly prompts and the ways that they're different than just those local level product prompts. Now for the next lesson in Toolbox. So to start off, why don't we go into this scribe filler, change my view. So just a little bit of a recap. Accessing the prompts of a subassembly can be done a couple different ways. Right-clicking in the open area of the prompts page, take this into our subassembly list. Keep in mind that there are some formula-driven values in here. So just think about the changes that you're going to want to make and if it's okay for them to be hard-valued or if they still need to retain that formula. Also on the left-hand side here, we have our subassembly library. This is a way to add subassemblies to your product. We're going to save this for another video where we're going to customize some products using these subassemblies. Right-click and add. You can also just double-click. I don't want to do that, so delete that guy. Now, like I said, we're going to get more into that a little bit later. Okay, the next way, obviously, showing subassembly prompts and takes you right into the subassembly itself. You'll notice a couple different ways that you can save a subassembly. These would be your save options. The one that we're going to be probably going into the most is going to be saving to the current subassembly or to the row. The other ones are meant for more sweeping changes through the entire product or through the entire project. Okay, so remember we had this flush with face prompt turned on from our global variables. Now this is living inside of the prompts page, right? Just as a checkbox. It's a prompt with a checkbox. Turn it on or turn it off. But I want to dig into the data a little bit more of this product, or the subassembly, I should say, and open up the spreadsheet. So you'll notice there as we select the subassembly itself, it opens up right to that worksheet, and that's our S worksheet for subassembly. So we have our cut parts, our hardware parts, if there were any. Most of the hardware parts are usually carried in finished faces or other subassemblies. And then if there was a nested subassembly, that's what we would call this, if there was anything in this list here, and then into the subassembly prompts. So we're just looking at the data in here. Typically, you're not changing anything unless you're adding a new prompt or doing some customizing to your library. All the different prompt names are in here. You can scroll down and find them. A much easier way to do that is to use our pull-down menu and go through the different prompt names that way. There's our flush with face prompt. And you see that value set to 1, also formula-driven. Up here in our text box, we have that formula, the global variable name. And also double-click in the cell, and that'll open up our edit formula box. So that's just a little sneak peek of some of the data inside of our subassembly. We'll close out of this. See, it's asking here again, do we want to save our scribe filler subassembly? We didn't make any changes, so no, I don't. But if you were, you'd also be prompted to tell Toolbox how it wants to be saved, whether it's at the current row or one of the other options. Last thing I want to show you in here is our part properties, which is another way to see our subassemblies inside of this product. So on the right-hand side, we have our parts that are for the carcass only. And on the left-hand side, we have the subassemblies. There's our scribe filler. Right-clicking and showing properties takes us to the same information that we saw in the spreadsheet, but just here in a different interface. So there's our cut parts, hardware, subassemblies, and the prompts. So the idea here is we're just getting a good understanding of how subassemblies are working inside of our product. Now quickly, we'll move over to this blind corner cabinet. So one other thing that I wanted to show you before we move on to our next video is what we can do when we've made a change to a subassembly. Let's get into another view here. So we made the change to this subassembly door. We've added the glass insert to it. But if there was anything that we've done and we wanted to go back and change that, rather than deleting the cabinet, you can go into part properties, find that subassembly with the red folder or that one that's been modified. If I were to right click and revert subassembly, it's going to take it back to how it was brought in originally from the library. Okay, so there's our slab door again, no glass insert. And opening up the subassembly prompts, we have the glass door prompt unchecked. So that's a quick way just to revert it back to its original state. Go ahead and turn that glass door back on since that's how we want to have it for this project. And I guess I lied. There is one more thing that I want to show you here. So using our edit design data command and selecting on the carcass takes you to our cut parts and hardware parts, subassemblies, prompts for just our carcass or cabinet box. Go to the subassemblies tab and we can see the different subassemblies that are being used. You can show all the parts or have them filtered by just the included ones. And over to the right, you can see we have our comments. So selecting on that finished faces subassembly, that's our left door. You can see the shelf adjustable, obviously self-explanatory. This finished face is our blind fascia. Now, because I want to look at the glass door prompt inside of the spreadsheet, I want to open up this subassembly. You can right click and show subassembly file. There's our upper left door. The different tabs again on the bottom. Go to our prompts tab. Now, if I didn't see it right in front of me, I could go up to our drop down list or pull down menu and find it that way. But there it is. There's our glass door. The value is 1, meaning that it's been checked. So it's turned on. And the control type, there's different control types that you can use for prompts. 4 is the checkbox. Other ones we'll get into when we start making some more customizations to our library. For more on working with subassemblies, be sure to check out some of our other training videos on how you can troubleshoot and rebuild subassemblies and products from the library. So just a quick video, kind of an overview on subassemblies, accessing them through our spreadsheet and part properties. Hopefully that helped a little bit. And now it's time to get into the next phase of this project when we start working on some shop drawing. So see you in our next video.